welcome to a brand new episode of Joe Semi. I am joined with a special guest today.
Hey guys, I'm Jimmy from Imagine Scent.
That's right. You probably have seen him before, and if you haven't, where have you been? I'm going to include a link to his channel down below so that you can follow him on his social media as well as his all of his other videos on YouTube. So make sure you support Timmy as well.
Thanks, guys.
I really appreciate you doing this video with me. This is
an
exciting thing to finally get to do something with you, and I've been dreaming of this moment. Lost a lot of sleep over it just because I'm like, I can't wait to meet Timmy.
I don't think I'm that special.
Nah, this guy's a good guy, and he really does some fabulous videos, and like I said, you gotta check him out. He does some really, really great job in his videos. So today, what I wanted to talk to you about was this company right here, which is called the Perfume Sommelier. And just from the word sommelier, the first thing that you think about is wine. And similarly, when a sommelier, who's a wine, somebody who's an expert in wine, comes to your table, he's a guy that you trust, that you want to make those recommendations for that bottle of wine, especially when you're spending good money on wine. So, the same concept has been brought to you in this box as a way for you to try out perfume, niche perfumes, by the way, from the comfort of your home. But here's the twist. Inside this box comes with a few things here. First of all, you get a little sheet right here, which will tell you the contents of the box. So we'll go back to this in a minute here. We also have a business card from the founder, which is Helen. Helen is the founder of this, and I'll include all their information so that you can make sure that you follow them and check them out as well. But here's the beautiful presentation right here. You get six decants, or I think they're 5 mil, right? Would you say they're 5 or 4 mil maybe?
Yeah, so I think 5 mil.
I think they're like 5 mil decants. And this isn't designer fragrance. You get six niche fragrances for $80. And there's two different series. Right now I'm working on series number 2. And this is a really different experience because none of these are labeled. So you have no clue what's inside. And we will not spoil it for you either. So make sure that you guys pick up a box and experience it for yourselves, because we don't want to spoil this for you. But what we want to sample this for you and just give you our thoughts on what's inside it, and just kind of share with you our experience with Sommelier. And because we're both niche frag heads, we love niche perfumes, I figured this would be a fun way to do a kind of a blind sniffing test without really anybody having any preconceived formulation of an opinion of what's inside. Like, you have no clue what's inside. That's kind of the fun of exploration, right? That gives it a new meaning to blind sniffing, literally, because you don't know what's inside. The only way you kind of know what's inside is this little booklet right here, which gives you a brief description of each item, and they are, each bottle is color-coded to match the description so that you can read just enough about it without really knowing what's inside. So, you wanna go ahead and try it and give it a sniff?
Yeah, sure.
We're gonna start with the first one, which is blue, and it has a picture of a coconut on it. We don't know what's gonna be on it, but let's just give it some thought and see what this is about. So we'll find the blue one. I'm gonna spray this side of it. And give it some time. Ooh, it smells great.
So I'm just rating these, right?
We're just gonna rate these, kind of give it your thoughts. If you know what it is, try to keep it to yourself. If you don't know what it is, then that's even better, but for now, I mean, what are your thoughts on that?
Creamy coconut lotion.
It does have that very...
Imagine
very,
like a lotion-y, like a coconut lotion, basically.
It's super tropical.
Yeah, tropical, creamy coconut lotion.
This smells like something that I would totally want to do for like summertime. Especially if you're kind of like in Miami and you just want to get that beach vibe going, and this smells like a really great scent for that. What do you think?
to me, I can't get over that lotion bar. I feel like
it is. Do you think it's very lotiony?
It's very lotiony. I feel like if I'm gonna wear this, I'll wear lotion. That moisturizes my skin too.
Probably a good thing to do anyway if you're gonna be in a tropical climate.
Yeah, I just have a problem with the lotiony smell. I think it smells great, but it smells too much like lotion for me.
Okay.
Like, yeah, like you can wear lotion and get a very similar vibe. That's the problem. And you're saying this is a niche fragrance, right?
This is a niche fragrance.
They have to be at least $100, I feel like.
At least, yeah. I mean, I would say that the coconut in this is pretty authentic. I don't feel like it's...
No, it smells fantastic.
Yeah.
It just smells too much like lotion for me to spend like over $100 in niche for it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it smells good. It smells good.
I'm going to go with number two, which is this one right here.
Ooh, what's that?
I don't know. Looks like some soap and almond or something possibly.
Maybe a cake?
Could be.
I don't know. That looks actually really good. Let's try it.
This does look really good. I am pretty excited about it. I can already tell this is going to be amazing. I'm already getting it in the air. I don't know if you are.
No.
Yes. Winner for me. This is amazing.
I smell it too close. I got the alcohol.
You got a little bit of the alcohol? That's alright.
It's like creamy, nutty.
Yeah, there's definitely an element of amber in this. It's really, really good.
Mm-hmm.
It's sweet. But I noticed there's a little dark and seductiveness to this thing right now. It's just really, really nice. What do you get from it?
Is that almond?
It's supposed to be. Like, I mean, based on the image, it's supposed to be some almond in there.
Yeah, some nutty almond. It's like a semi gourmand.
It is definitely gourmand.
It's not bad. It's nice.
I like it a lot. I don't know what it is, so I'm not going to spoil it because I don't know what it is. It smells very familiar, though. I think it does smell familiar. This is definitely the type of scent that I would love to wear. I see this as a fall, cold weather.
Definitely.
So on a day like today, it's like 50-something in Vegas right now, and it's perfect. This is very, very nice. I really like that. All right, let's go to the next one, the orange one. It's this one right here. This is the orange one right here.
I think it's gonna be spicy.
I think it's gonna be spicy.
Is it cinnamon? Is it anise?
Star anise, yep.
I don't know what that is.
Incense, possibly?
Incense.
Yeah. Let's go for that. Let's see what happens here. Spray a little bit down below. Are you getting any of this? Can you smell any of it?
Oh, yes, I do.
Ooh, ho, ho, ho. Oh, this is really smoky.
Very cinnamony. I get the star anise.
Do you?
It's like I'm smelling a jar of cinnamon.
Really?
Yeah, a jar of like mixed spices.
I got an initial blast of smoke. There's definitely a smoky
element. Yeah.
There's a smoky element to this thing for sure. It too smells familiar. But I'm not 100% sure what it is.
It reminds me of spiced tea. Like,
spiced tea?
Yeah, yeah, cinnamon tea, you know.
Okay. Like something you smell like Teavana when you walk by.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. It smells like something like Teavana. Yeah.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Like chai spices.
Yeah, if you're interested in like something that's smoky, this is really, really cool.
That's my favorite out of the three. The one
so far. Yeah, I actually like that. I like number two the most, but let's go on to number.
It's just that one's just very warming. The cinnamon, the spices, and the tea kind of vibe, super cozy. Imagine wearing that like at night or casual Sunday.
Oh yeah,
very winter time.
Let's see. So number four, as we can tell by the picture, looks like something that is very citric. It has grapefruit in it, which could be either bitter or could be very sour. We'll see. So let's take a look at number four. Yeah, I'm getting definitely the grapefruit vibe out of this thing. It's not overly citrus. I know sometimes the citrus can be extremely, I don't know, know, sharp. This is not too sharp. You say it's sharp citrus, so.
I feel like I know what this is, but I'm not gonna say it.
Yeah.
I can't say it.
So you're saying it's Bath and Body Works?
No, it's not Bath and Body Works.
These are niche.
Bath and Body Works is niche. Oh yeah, I think I know what this is.
You think? Okay.
Yeah.
That's cool.
It smells nice, citrusy, smooth, it's not piercing. It's like soapy citrus.
Soapy
it smells
citrus?
Nice.
Yeah.
There's a lot of niche that smells like that.
Very cool. Alright, so we're down to two more. Let's take a look at what our last two are. Number five and number six. Number five.
Tobacco.
I believe number five
tobacco.
Could be tobacco. It's either tobacco or it's hay. I'm going with tobacco as well. This is very exciting. So this is number five right here. All right, let's give number five a shot.
I don't know if you guys can hear the music.
I hope not, because then I'll owe YouTube some money. We'll have to
owe Lady Gaga money.
I owe Lady Gaga money. That won't be cool.
She's already rich.
I know, but she's not gonna record this. And I owe Michael Jackson money and everybody else is playing. Ooh, I don't know. This is different.
Saffron?
Yes. That was not hay or tobacco.
Yeah, well, I was guessing saffron.
Saffron would be more yellower, but the picture definitely made it look a little.
Yep. Saffron.
Saffron?
I think it's saffron.
I get that
my
too.
Nose is messing with it. Because it's definitely not tobacco. It's definitely not hay. It's just saffron. It smells nice.
I like it too.
It has like an ylang-ylang vibe to it too.
Yeah.
Do you get that? Like a yellow floral ylang-ylang kind
yep.
of feeling.
Now that you say that, yes, I do get that.
It smells feminine.
It does.
Definitely smells feminine. It's nice, it's pleasing. It's simple.
Yeah, and when I first put it on, this thing, the air that you smelled very much like said saffron. Like that was the first thing that I got. That was initial blast was saffron. But now that you mention it, it does go to the floral world. Alright, so
it's nice but it's simple.
We're on the last one, which is number six. And
an orange flower.
I see roses. I think it's roses.
Yeah, rose too.
But the juice, I gotta show you the juice. It's
orange.
Pretty dark. But I will say that this is probably going to, I thought it would be more like your amber type fragrance, but who knows what this will be.
Maybe.
Let's give it a shot and see what we get. Wow, this is rich. I mean, it's definitely floral. And I typically don't go for florals. Y'all know me already, watch my channel. I'm not a floral guy, but that is really good. Sometimes I like it when a floral catches me by surprise. That one really caught me by surprise. It's a little darker than that.
There's an animalic touch to it.
There is, yeah. Which means it's
like a very soft animalic. It's not like, it's not stinky animalic.
Do you think it's like a musky rose, or do you think it's more like a woody rose?
I think it's more of like a woody rose.
Is there some oud in there?
Yeah, more oud than rose. Smells nice. But again, another simple one. I feel like they pick a lot of simple fragrances to get, like simple composition. It doesn't mean it's bad. It's very easy to understand. When you smell them, it's like, okay, there's like two or three notes in there that you can pick out right away.
Yeah.
It's not overly complex. Some people like that.
Yeah, and it's also good that it isn't overly complex, because the person who is the market for this right here is really the person that's on a mission to discover their fragrance. And if they're overwhelmed with something that is just too complicated, you won't really appreciate the complication if you don't know what you're getting anyway. For something like this, like just being able to see a little picture of what sort of you're gonna get is all really that you need. And I kind of like this concept. I really do. And I think it gives it a new meaning again to blind buying, blind sniffing. It's true blind sniffing. I mean, it's not blind sniffing if you know what you're going to smell in advance. except for, I mean, you kind of have a picture to help you out there. So what was your favorite from this bunch?
The anise one.
Three.
The cinnamon anise one. Yeah.
So number three was your favorite. Number two was my favorite. Because I thought it was really warm and sexy and seductive. But they mentioned in this that you really don't want to mix these. But I could totally see how number two and number three, if they were mixed together, you kind of get a really good vibe. Yeah. So do you want to try that and see what happens?
Yeah, sure.
Let's see what happens when you mix green with orange. Because I have a feeling we might be onto something. Let's see if we came up with some really cool combination. Now we have to get rid of the alcohol. Because of course, like anything, we have, well, there's alcohol. I think we're onto something really good. Check this out.
Smells really nice. I get that the cinnamon, the cozy spices in the background, but I get the nuttiness on top. The creamy nuttiness. I think this is really good.
Yeah, I think we just came out with a really good combination. We don't know what's inside, but just to mix number two and three together did come off pretty nice because you got the smoky vibe, you got the spicy vibe, but I think that the sweetness helps bring it to a nicer level. So that's pretty much it. That's a perfume sommelier. I'll include all the information that you need down below so that you can make sure that you check them out. They do have an Instagram page, so I'll include that as well, so you can follow them there. And then if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to them. They're really good about responding. And if you want to be a part of this, it's just $80, either for Series 1 or Series 2, so you can choose whichever one you want to get. And they're going to continue to come out with new series, by the way. And definitely check it out. So that's it. Thank you for joining us. This is Timmy. Make sure to check out his videos. Make sure to follow him, like, subscribe, do all the fun things. And also on my channel as well, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Also, don't forget to follow me here and on Instagram. And then also, don't forget the notification bell at the top so that you can continue to get great content in the future. Thanks again for tuning in and have a nice day.
Bye.
Bye-bye.